So I'm going to start this video with a rant, Gary.
Okay.
A rant. Yeah. I am not happy at all. Last week I went down to see the House of the Future.
Okay.
It's a little bit like the Truman Show.
Yeah.
Well, when I got there, I was not happy with what I saw inside.
Okay, so this sounds like a 180 degrees turn away from ground and air source heat pumps in, Gordon?
No, the heat pump's fine, okay. And that is, I think, the future. We can debate that. We saw those ground source heat pumps in Wales. Air source heat pumps, big box goes on the outside of your house.
Yeah. Right.
And the manufacturers are working hard, obviously, to minimise the size of them, make the design as aesthetic as possible. Yeah, and then somebody goes and plonks two red and yellow isolators in a prominent position on the outside of your house.
Okay, so they're suggesting those air source heat pumps require an emergency isolator, and we don't think they do, so please leave your comments below on that one. But you think design-wise, you've come up with one that's maybe more pleasing to the eye, is that right?
Yeah, on two fronts. So yeah, we'll get that emergency isolator out of the way first. Yeah, we think it should be a grey and black isolator.
Okay, so grey and black isolator. So if I'm remembering correctly, they're the isolators that lock in the off position, and they're the isolators you can lock in the on position, where obviously the red and yellow ones, we can only lock them off, can't we, Gordon?
Yeah, that's it. So think of that scenario. So this one, you can't lock it on.
Right.
Yeah, so what would your son possibly have done, Gary?
Well, thinking back through experience, obviously we had a normal standard socket outlet in the garden feeding things such as pumps, okay, important to leave those on, and if you left him on his own, he'd be a little bit of a devil. He'd go around turning off switches. He had a thing for switches, so imagine he could go to that isolator and possibly turn off the air source heat pump if I had it in that position.
Yeah, and yeah, we know you're not so fond of one of your neighbours in particular. You could come back late at night and decide to just exercise your right and turn his heat pump off overnight.
I could.
So my advice to him would be to make sure if you're fitting an air source heat pump, use one of these, because obviously you can lock it in the on position,
okay,
which is important, and obviously in the off position when someone comes to do some maintenance on the heat pump. So again, we don't think there's a reason to fit an emergency one.
No, in that location at all. Mm. And design-wise, obviously that being grey and off-grey, that matched the heat pump that you saw, obviously, as well, didn't it?
It did. But when we talk about design,
right, okay, yeah, design. This one
from Scarme has been designed.
Okay, so what suggests it has been designed?
Well, as I often say, form follows function.
Right, okay. Yeah.
So let's start with the front. Nice, flush front isolator there. But if I turn this one over on the back, it actually has been designed, because it says on the back here, Trussardi and Bolloni design.
Oh, right, okay, they're true Italian names, I would suggest. You're probably thinking of the Ferrari factory, and the new Ferrari comes out, the Gazzino, okay, designed by those two gentlemen, wouldn't it?
Yeah, so obviously we can say this is as geeky as you'll ever get. I think this is possibly the best looking isolator I've ever seen. But obviously, as I said, form follows function.
Yeah,
but some of the great functions, obviously having that switch recessed in there means it's less susceptible to damage. Obviously does look a lot better on the outside of your house.
Yeah, and those ones that protrude, aren't they often the ones that have got a screw in the centre? And I've seen it before when you've had an emergency style isolator that doesn't need to be a necessary emergency one. They take that screw out and leave it, don't they, in that position on, so nobody can come along and turn
it
off.
Yeah, 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 to remove the red handle.
Yes.
But obviously when someone does come along to do some maintenance, they can't switch it off, or have to get the pliers out, which is obviously not very good practice, and at that stage it's very hard to lock it off.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. So when I'm thinking about now actually using it, we've used these over in the other studio, haven't we? We've been fitting our EnviroVent extraction system. We've chosen one of these isolators to fit in there, so we've had to play around with it. Let's go through some of the great features we think when we're installing it.
Yeah, so this great feature, so it starts with the front cover. Obviously safety first. You can only remove the cover, not just by taking out the four screws in the corner, but it has to be in the off position.
Okay, yeah.
Open it up and you've got captive screws at the back.
Okay, so that's always a classic, and you take a cover off the front and the next thing you're scrambling around trying to find those screws.
Yep, and they hold the gasket in place, and then obviously under the gasket, if we look at the rear of the enclosure, the actual fixing screw locations are under the gasket as well.
Right.
So we're not having to drill through the back of the enclosure to mount it to the wall.
Which means it keeps its IP rating, doesn't it?
Yes, it is. And for IP ratings, and this one is IP66.
Right.
Jets of water, and then we step up to IP69 for hot jets of water, so if you're in the food industry and things like that.
Okay, and then we think about the holes to get into that, and we drilled some holes into our enclosure, and they nicely set those out as well, where they would like you to position it, and the size of hole they can position in that location, as well as having holes positions in the back and in the other side of the bottom. But there is no top and bottom, is there?
No, it's completely reversible. So you can, you can use the ones that are pre-marked with the drill positions for different size of obviously common cable gland, or you've got some more regular looking knockout positions on the bottom if you were, say, looping in and looping out.
Okay.
That's well thought out. Yeah, but you can put it either way and you can put the lid on either way, which I'm not sure you can do that on all isolators. I think there is a definite top and bottom. But also, as well, you're thinking of that first fix install, you can easily remove the switch mechanism from it.
So that gives you a couple of benefits, though, doesn't it? It gives you more room in which to obviously work when you're trying to gland into it. Also, doesn't it, from a maintenance point of view, if for some reason you had to replace that isolator, maybe you were changing between a 2, a 3, or a 4-pole one, you could just clip in and swap out, couldn't you? Yeah. Or maybe under maintenance, you have to change it altogether.
Yeah, and if you're a regular Scarme user, you'll notice, there's the actual switch mechanism in here. It's the same one we had on that GRP socket that we looked at in a previous video and is installed also outside this building. So yeah, bags of room in there. You know, very easy. The good thing as well, this isn't sort of a, there's only really one position that switch can go.
Right.
Yeah, so sometimes you'll see a DIN rail in there and it can slide, and you can't line the mechanism up. This one, as long as it's in the off position,
you're locked and you're ready to go.
Mm. So, lots to like about it. When we think about current range, we've got the smaller enclosure here, which goes up to 20 to 40 amps.
Okay, yeah.
And there is a larger size that takes us up to 63 to 80 amps. And there's a few different pole options, isn't there?
Yeah, there's the 2-pole, the 3-pole with switch neutral, okay, and a 4-pole as well, isn't there?
Yeah, so we'd be interesting to get your thoughts on that. We were 3-pole plus neutral and then a 4-pole.
Yes.
Is there a difference between them?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, comment below on those. We'll also leave a link for that other video when we installed the Scarme socket outside as well, above our header in the description as well, won't we?
Yeah, so pretty robust. Obviously, it's thermoplastic and it's IK9. So
okay, pretty strong then.
Pretty solid unit.
Another thing dear to our hearts here at eFIXX is that torque setting. And on the isolators, it's 0.8 newton meters of torque. And when we go in and start talking about, you can see that cage clamp coming down and clamping on terminations.
Yeah, high quality terminations. They also give you the torque setting for the front cover as well. Obviously, that is quite important, and people sometimes forget if you over tighten a gasket, you can actually cause a water ingress problem as well. But all in all, this is a fantastic range of isolators, and I would argue again, possibly the best looking isolators that we've ever seen.
Okay, the other end of the spectrum is down here. Is there any reason why we've got this one on the table?
This is for the viewers, really. Okay. So we also were sent, when we had a look at these isolators, this one is for fire-rated equipment. So this isolator will obviously keep going in a fire situation.
Right, okay.
So I'm thinking this possibly used on smoke extract systems.
Yeah.
But however, we're always open to your comments. If you've fitted this kind of isolator, we'd love to know some of the applications that you've been fitting it for. But for now, what do you think of this gorgeous looking isolator here? What do you think about the use of obviously the grey and the black in those more maintenance based situations? What do you think of heat pumps in general?
As always, we're interested in your feedback, okay? On these isolators from Scarme, have you fitted them before? Do you think they're as beautiful as Gordon? No. So I'll rephrase that. Do you think they're as beautiful as Gordon thinks they are? Please leave all those comments below and I'll try and get back to as many as I can.